Pixelkin.
We're exploring Star Wars, the Skylands, and a labyrinth of lies on This Week in Family Gaming. Hey Pixelkinners, we're back from a busy weekend at Portland Retro Gaming Expo. Thanks to everyone who stopped by our booth and signed up for our newsletter, and thanks to that one guy who bought our only mug. You know who you are. Recently, Project Spark was released for Xbox One and PC. It's a game that lets you build games with practice. Project Spark lets users create their own worlds and add gameplay elements. You can create enemies and obstacles, paint entire landscapes. It's kind of intimidatingly huge. You can also play games that other users have created. Project Spark encourages you to remix those games by adding your own modifications. Above all, Project Spark teaches you that designing games is really hard work. So if game design is your passion, Project Spark is a really cool way to jump into it. The game is available as a free download from projectspark.com. To learn more about it, read our review. This week we're putting the spotlight on Star Wars The Old Republic, which is a free-to-play online role-playing game. If you're looking for a multiplayer game for your family that has some substance to it, The Old Republic is a great choice. Because you're making decisions that put you either on the dark side or the light side of the Force, it's a good opportunity to talk about ethics. For example, why is it sometimes harder to make the good choice? Tough moral questions aside, The Old Republic is a cinematic game with a great story. So if you like Star Wars, take the opportunity to start ruling the galaxy with your kid. For more on The Old Republic, check out Jason DeCantor's editorial on the site. Is anything better than cute kids, robots, and science? I don't think so. Our coverage of Geek Girl Con has all of the above, including an interview with an awesome little girl who was selling her own comics at the convention. To hear her story and find out more about what kids thought about Geek Girl Con, check out our video linked below. Nancy Drew and the Labyrinth of Lies recently came out for the PC. Like the rest of the Nancy Drew series from Her Interactive, this is a challenging puzzle game. Make that a very challenging puzzle game. Nancy has to solve the mystery of some art thefts, and along the way you actually end up learning a bit about Greek mythology, architecture, and even a little bit about Greek writing. The game is rated E10+, but make no mistake, the puzzles are a lot harder than that. If you like mystery solving and cool female protagonists, this could be the game for you. Read more about it in our review. Finally, Skylanders Trap Team recently came into our lives, and it is here to stay. This action-adventure game is available for basically every console, and like Disney Infinity, it uses collectible figurines to represent the character that you're playing. And Skylanders has lots of characters to choose from. As a Skylander, you go through tons of gorgeous, magical levels, beating up bad guys, and searching for treasure. The game made me laugh out loud with its dialogue and colorful characters. Read more about how to play and what we thought about the game in our review. That's it for this week. On Saturday the 25th, I'll be participating in the Extra Life Gaming Marathon to raise money for children's hospitals by playing video games for 24 hours straight. Wish me luck. I'm on a team with Engage Family Gaming. If you'd like to donate, check out the link to my fundraising page linked below. And if you have any suggestions for what I should play, leave them in the comments. Finally, don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and visit pixelkin.org to sign up for our newsletter and get all the best gaming news delivered right to your inbox once a week. Have a great weekend!